And the Falcon Heavy rolled out overnight to the launch pad. It is almost ready for liftoff. Its third launch from here, but its first that will come at night. At Launch Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center, the Falcon Heavy is upright and in position for a test firing of its 27 rocket engines. This follows days of assembly in a hangar near the launch pad, where the triple-barreled rocket is put together with explosive bolts. The world's largest rocket is tentatively scheduled to launch Monday night, and those explosive bolts will come into play just after launch when the two side boosters separate. They'll return for a landing at the Cape and should be visible for some miles around as they touch down, although the best view for this is on camera. But for the liftoff itself, when those 27 engines light up at night for the first time, the view will be good for hundreds of miles and should attract big crowds, just as it did last time.
And the landing is one of my favorite things to see. The first time I ever saw it, like a pencil landing on its eraser, was pretty amazing to see.
But this isn't about spectators or about launching a little red car this time. Taxpayers are footing the bill for the launch, and the rocket will carry several payloads for NASA and the Air Force. An atomic clock for space navigation and some space weather research equipment will be on board. And the Falcon Heavy is the cheapest way to get them into space. And we've got a great view of the Falcon Heavy at Launch Pad 39A here at the Kennedy Space Center. The liftoff on Monday night at 11:30 p.m. is dependent on whether they can get a test firing done. That test firing should be soon, perhaps tonight, but SpaceX will not confirm what time. We're live at the Kennedy Space Center. Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.